In this video, I'm going to go over the basics of paper mache. Paper mache is basically using pieces of strips of newspaper, dipping it into a paste, squeezing off the extra, and then laying it over top of some kind of mold that we have. What the actual paper mache paste is that we have is Elmer's paper mache paste. It's basically a powder that I mix with water, and it's just a type of glue. So it's something you can dip your fingers in and it's not gonna hurt you or anything. All right, so to start out, we'll take a strip, single strip of newspaper, dip it all the way in the paper mache paste, and I'm squeezing it between my fingers to pull off all the extra stuff. These should not be dripping wet. If it's dripping wet, it's gonna make a mess and it's gonna take a really long time to dry. All right, so I have my wet piece of newspaper, and on my mold, I'm just gonna put it on here and smooth the whole thing out. You gotta really make sure you press down on here. Otherwise, you're gonna end up with bubbles underneath and you're not even gonna be able to tell what this is by the time it's done. Take another one, dip it in, squeeze off all the extra, and overlap that one with the first one that you put on. Go through, smooth everything down. And then just keep going until you have the entire mold covered with the paper mache paste and newspaper. Gotta make sure that you really smooth stuff down, otherwise you're gonna end up with a bunch of wrinkles and folds. If at any point you realize that there's a bunch of stuff dripping on here, scoop it off and just put it right back in the bucket. All right, and what I'm aiming to do is put one full layer of newspaper on this, and then I don't need to even let it dry. I can put a second layer on and a third layer on. All right, so I want three layers. If I do one layer of this, it's gonna be as flimsy as a piece of newspaper and it's gonna really fall apart and you're not gonna be able to work with it. Once you have three layers on, it should be pretty durable and you can do your project with it. Once it dries, you can completely pop the mask off and we'll do a project with it. So, two layers, the first two layers are just gonna be newspaper. The third layer is gonna be a layer of white paper. And the reason I'm gonna put a third layer with white paper on is because when we go to paint this, if you paint over top of the newspaper, you're gonna see all the pictures and words through the paint. Because the paint, or you'll have to put like 20 coats of paint on to cover it. All right, so if you cover it with white paper at the very end, then all you need to do is one coat of paint on the white paper. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and skip forward a little bit. I'm gonna finish this and I'll come back and show you the layer of white paper. I'm finishing up the paper mache mask. The third layer is a layer of plain white paper. And just to have a couple more pieces to put on it. Making sure to smooth all this down really, really well. Making sure to cover all the areas with three layers. If you only have two layers, you're gonna have a really soft spot in your mask. All right, so I got just a little section here to finish. Finally, the last piece that I'm gonna put on has my name on it. You can't write your name on this with a pen right now, and all of these are going to look the same. So make sure you put your name on it and then just paper mache this piece right to your mask. Just going to stick it on there like a regular piece. All right, once I have this looking like it's finished, I'm going to just go back through and really smooth down any wrinkles, any bumps. Squeeze out any extra paper mache paste. Really kind of finish the mask. You can see it's kind of squeezing out at the bottom. The drier it is, the more the stuff you get out, the quicker it's gonna dry. Smooth it down so you can see the facial features. And that's it. In the next video, we'll go on to adding designs to these.